Welcome to Unfiltered from Home. I'm Essie Cupp. Now, I never thought that I'd say this, but a new ad from the Biden campaign is speaking my love language. In a nutshell, it's promising to give me my life back. The spot opens with this question to voters. Remember when you didn't have to think about the president every single day, and instead there was someone in that office who thought about you? Well, according to CNN, the ad is part of a national campaign targeting black voters, but its unquestionable appeal is far from limited to just that one constituency. That line captures how a lot of people feel, a Biden aide told CNN. You want to be able to pick up your phone in the morning and not be outraged or scared. You want a government that works, they said. Or a government you simply don't have to think about all that often, I say. A government that exists merely to govern and not to consume your every waking thought. A government that revolves around you and not the other way around. Now, while I hear that there are supposedly people out there who don't spend the majority of their time obsessing over politics and the all caps state of our nation, for many of us, politics in the era of Trump has demanded our nearly undivided attention. That's partly because he demands it, his constant tweeting, the 2016 campaign rallies that never ended, the narcissism, the martyrdom, and desperate cries for adoration. This president is ubiquitous. Now, it's my job to obsess over this stuff, so I do it. But many everyday Americans also feel as though politics has become too important to ignore. Some are part of the so-called resistance, the legions of Americans who, for one reason or all of them, believe President Trump is the single greatest threat to our democracy and way of life. Some are Trump supporters who believe that Trump is quite simply the last thing standing between white civilization and the culture-canceling Visigoths. Either way, for many Americans, politics increasingly determines where we live, how we spend our time, what we watch, who our friends are. Now, everything from watching football to mask wearing has become politicized. And that is, to put it gently, awful. Politics and government weren't meant to be the omnipresent center of gravity in our daily lives, all but replacing family, community, work, or church. Our elected officials were never meant to be celebrities or cult figures who demanded our undying attention and adoration. Presidential elections weren't meant to be four-year-long events that bleed seamlessly into one another. Our psychological well-being should not be dependent on who is in office. And yet, American anxiety levels are at a fever pitch, and politics is a huge factor. Per the American Psychiatric Association's Stress in America survey, in 2018, 69% said the future of the nation was a significant source of stress. Those numbers rose in the wake of the 2016 election and long before the added stress of the COVID-19 pandemic. This is simply not sustainable, and that is why the Biden campaign is very smart to not only address the constant chaos of the Trump administration, but to promise to return the outsized stature of politics to its rightfully diminutive place if elected in November. Now, it's been harder, obviously, during the pandemic, the exact time when you need government to step into an outsized role. But Trump has shrunk from that responsibility, instead making it about him, accusing Democrats of using a virus that's on track to kill more than 200,000 Americans under his watch to hurt his reelection. A good grasp of the role of government has proven elusive to Trump during the racial and civil unrest that's tearing through the nation, too. Instead of using the bully pulpit to calm fears, he's used tear gas on peaceful protesters and threatened military involvement, only ratcheting up the tension. Trump's understanding of government is almost always wrong. Absent when you need it most, intrusive when you need it least, and existing only to fulfill his own self-interested needs. We could sure use a break from this. Now, more than ever, we need to focus on healing our families and our communities and not on the federal government. And we need a president who gets that. So I don't need Joe Biden to promise to solve all our problems. He can't, and he shouldn't. But if he's promising to be less important in my life and yours, Well, that's frankly the kind of relief we all desperately need. Okay, that's it for me. See you next time.